Hello, everyone, and welcome to Memorial Gymnasium on the campus of Henry Ford College in lovely Dearborn, Michigan. I'm Jeff Lowe, along with Leland Sine, sitting in for Eric Pate this evening as the Hawks will face Schoolcraft College in a going down the stretch game here and for playoff positioning and much more. It's an important game. The last time these two teams met, Leland, tell us about what's going on here.
Well, Schoolcraft beat this team about January 27th, 90 to 84. So it's a revenge game, too, as well as you mentioned, playoff positioning. But all these guys know each other, so you know they want to win.
Henry Ford gets on the board first. And Schoolcraft in the dark uniforms, Henry Ford in the white uniforms.
Also, there's extra motivation. Schoolcraft have two more games left after this one, but they're both on the road. So this is their last home game. Everyone wants to win their last home game, right, Jeff?
You mean Henry Ford has to?
Yes, Henry Ford wants to win their last, this is their last home game of the season.
Hard drive to the basket. And picking up the foul is Keon Henderson. He'll go to the line shooting two. Let me get those starting lineups for you. For Henry Ford, you got Scott, Willis, Hayes, and Ritt. And for Schoolcraft College, you got Stevens, Jackson, Lee, Thorne, and Henderson. And Schoolcraft, coached by E.J. Harrelson. You know that name, familiar name in the Detroit basketball community.
He also has a couple of great assistants from Detroit basketball community, William Pearson and Kenneth Flowers. So Schoolcraft has a solid staff.
Henry Ford off to a 6-1 lead here over Schoolcraft. Ford is in a 3-2 zone defense. It's causing Schoolcraft some problems right now. Shot by Henderson off the mark. Whistles blow, and that basket will not count.
Jeff, in the 90-84 victory by Schoolcraft at Schoolcraft, Scott led the way, dropping in 19. And Carlos Johnson and Alan Rick chipped in 15 and 13 in the loss.
In league play, this Schoolcraft team is coming in 6-5 in the division. Henry Ford 8-3. Henry Ford overall is 16-7, and Schoolcraft is 14-11 overall. You just joining us? We're in the first half here at Henry Ford College. It's the Hawks and the Ocelots from Schoolcraft. Henry Ford picking up full half-court defense there and pushing Schoolcraft back. In the zone. Drive baseline and a nice dish inside to the big fella, number 22, Marshall Thorne.
Yeah, a couple of keys to the game for Schoolcraft defensively, Jeff, is making sure they put a hold on Daniel Lee. The six-six fella from Southfield Groves is averaging 16 points a game, and they lead rebound to 8 a game. So they got to keep him under wraps, as well as Malachi Prince Jackson, who's tossing in 15.
There's the outlet. Willis pulls for the three. That's off the mark.
Good look there. That's a good shot. We can live with those.
Your officials for this evening's contest is Aaron Scott, Kevin Klein, and Christian Smith. Ritt from outside.
Ritt's had a solid season. The Hawks have been led in scoring this year by Chauncey. Chauncey Willis averaging 19 a game. And he's closely followed by...
Nice block that time by Carter. And Schoolcraft stayed with it and put the ball back in the bucket. Scott, jumper is off tomorrow.
Again, Chauncey's the leading scorer, followed by Shannon Brooks at 15 a game. So I'm sure Coach Shepard want to make sure to get them guys going. One of the unique things about this Henry Ford team, Jeff, is that the two leading scorers, Willis and Bond, they have five guys that average almost 9 points a game. That is rare. Five, so that could be almost five guys in double figures. So this is a well-balanced team. Some people think their record of 16-7 is, you know, not what they want, but they're 8-3 in the conference. They've had a long, Coach Shepard has had some good success over the years, don't you think, Jeff?
Oh, definitely.
So maybe that's why that 16-7, you know, we want to look at even more, but that's a great season.
Outside shot is good by Daniel Lee. And that puts him within a point. 9-8 your score. In favor of Henry Ford. A nice dish that time by Hayes. And a nice finish by the big man, number 5, Shannon Carter.
That's where you like to see your 6'8 guys. Close to the hoop, very near it.
Nice roll to the basket. That's going to be a travel.
Well, some folks call me old school, Jeff, because, you know, I get the ball inside, but it's the three-point shooting world. Even the 6'8 guys shoot them.
Well, even the seven-footers shoot them nowadays.
You're right. The seven-footers, too.
Bonds from outside. That one's off the mark. Ritt there for the loose ball. Tried to go inside to Carter. Carter gets the loose ball and dunks it.
They like that. As Kirk Cousins said, how you like that? How you like me now?
Carter doing it on both ends. Snatches down the rebound. Up quickly to Ritt. Inside to Carter, that's the way to go. I like to see that. When a big man is working that hard, rewarding.
Yes, indeed.
On the Ritt comes out. Ziegler comes in and Rosenberg comes in for Henry Ford. These players were honored, especially the players that are graduating and are moving on to the next level. Turn around by Willis. Three-point shot. Off the mark by Daniel Lee. Daniel Lee, the leading scorer on Schoolcraft. Ziegler on the wing, looking inside to Rosenberg. Rosenberg couldn't find anybody in the paint. And that looks like an offensive foul. Yes, it is.
Yeah, I like the idea. I want to see the big fella be aggressive. But you just can't lower the shoulder. Can't do it.
Carter comes out. Coach Shepard, pleased about that one.
Those are the kind of fouls Coach Shepard and his staff can live with, though, because he was a hustler.
Excuse me. And that's going to be a travel. Noah Range couldn't get his footing right and stumbled his way into the paint and traveled and turned the ball over to Henry Ford. Ziegler will try a three from outside. That one's off the mark. Malachi Black.
Good rebound.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
And the tip in by Ziegler. Eight, your score.
That's those oh no plays. Oh no, don't shoot that three. Well, oh yeah, good hustle for the rebound.
That was Jackson for three for Schoolcraft.
Jackson is a leading scorer for Schoolcraft, so they got to keep an eye on him.
Well, it's to Rosenberg. Ziegler up high for the rebound, kicks it back out. Willis looking inside, pass may have been a little too hard. Malachi Black, it went off one of the Schoolcraft players, so Henry Ford will retain possession underneath the basket. Back into Black, Black goes hard to the basket, that one's blocked.
Daniel Lee, leading scorer and a rebounder for Schoolcraft.
This zone pressure, this zone defense has been giving Schoolcraft some problems early on in this contest.
Chauncey has really had a good season for Henry Ford this year, averaging close to 19 a game, and he's also the team's leading assist at seven. Seven assists a game will get you a scholarship at the next level.
Hard to the basket, Rosenberg. Picking up the foul on that play. And that will send Jackson to the line shooting two. And you mentioned Willis, I believe he does have an opportunity to go on to the next level.
Where's that, Jeff?
I believe it's Western Michigan. I have to check that.
Okay.
And we have a visit from one of your old buddies right there.
Oh, the Hawk is in the house.
Henry the Hawk.
I think he's going to come over there and peck you on the head, Jeff. Here he comes.
Willis looking to drive.
There you go. Willis is the glue that holds this team together. There's no doubt about that. Last time they lost to Schoolcraft, he didn't have one of his best games. He only scored about 7 points. So I know he personally is looking to make amends, Jeff.
Willis with the steal.
And that great pass.
Quickly, Rosenberg, he has it knocked out of his hand. And actually, they call that out on Henry Ford, and Rosenberg's like,
what? It was a great pass, better defense.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's like that, isn't it?
Yes, it is. 17-13, your score, 11-26 here in the first half of play. You're watching Henry Ford College Basketball on the Henry Ford Streaming Network. I'm Jeff Lowe, along with Lily Stein, bringing you all the action this evening. Three-point shot attempt, no good. Ziegler with the rebound. Up quickly to Willis. Willis driving hard to the basket. Left hand off the mark. Black with the rebound, and he's hacked on the putback, and he'll go to the line shooting two.
We have a nice-sized crowd coming here, the kind of vocal. They're milling in for the last home game at Henry Ford College.
It's going to be a 30-second timeout. Jay Helson and his coaching staff wants to talk it over. Five, it sure has been a pleasure bringing you all the action of Henry Ford College basketball on the Henry Ford Streaming Network all season long. Hopefully we'll have a few more home games to bring you with the playoffs about to start.
So if they get in the playoffs, they'll get a home game?
It's a possibility.
Okay. Sort of like the Lions had the possibility of getting a home game.
It's a possibility.
Everything's got to go right.
It's all a possibility.
But Coach Shepherd and his staff has done a great job with this program over the years, having them compete at a very, very high level. Consistently, right, Jeff? Year in and year out?
Year in and year out.
I think an 8-3 conference record right now is competing. Win this game, they'll be 9-3.
Well, Henry Ford has gotten a reputation of being a good option for kids to come to. With that dunk right there by Schoolcraft College, number 22, Marshall Thorne on the dunk.
And that's a great thing you said, Jeff. It's been a good option. And kids need those options because all of us aren't on the same level when we graduate from high school. And when you can have opportunities like this, you know, to help hone your skills and grow and mature as a person, and you still can achieve all your goals as an athlete.
Ziegler goes up high, and his leg actually comes down on the shoulder of Thorne.
Yeah, almost kicked him in the head.
Yeah. Malachi Black checks out, and Johnson checks in. Johnson has been in and out of the lineup due to some injuries. He's finally getting in the flow of things here. 20-17 is your score. 9:50 and counting here in the first half if you're just joining us. Ziegler hard to the basket. Ziegler gets it up and draws the foul.
Ziegler making his presence known under that basket early in this first half. Coming off the bench showing, you know, a little hustle and a little grit. And he'll be back next year, though, because he's just a freshman.
That
one
is
of our King, Martin Luther King freshman.
And he has been working his way into the lineup, which is a good sign for Ziegler.
And for those of you that don't know, that Ziegler name is well known in Detroit over for years. Heck, I played with one of the Zieglers at McKenzie back in 1972.
Missed dunk there. Ziegler gets the loose ball out. Rosenberg from outside is
all
good.
Right now.
'17. That looked like a travel, and it is. It's going to be a timeout called on the floor. Officials are pointing over to the bench of Schoolcraft. Might have been a little bit of extracurricular activity after the play right there. And the officials are just discussing that matter right now. And they will assess a technical. And Henry Ford will get an opportunity to shoot the technical. So a technical foul assessed against Schoolcraft College. It looks like Britt will shoot the technicals. It's So Rick will go to the line and shoot the technical foul.
Adam has been solid for this team, averaging almost 10 points a game and giving them some strong rebounding for Coach Shepard and his squad.
Bonds brings it up. Looking inside to Johnson. Johnson has given them some additional physical presence inside. Rosenberg with the putback flying through the paint there.
And when I was talking earlier about Henry Ford's strength, the bench play, having almost 10 guys on the team averaging 10 points a game, as well as Chauncey and Bonds averaging 19 and 15.
Henry Ford in that zone again. And giving Schoolcraft some problems. 5 seconds on the shot clock.
Yeah, Rosenberger is one of those, Jeff, that's averaging 9 points a game coming off the bench. And he's giving them 5 points here in about 4 or 5 minutes of play.
Ziegler now checks out. Rosenberg checks out. Ziegler also has been giving them some good minutes in the recent games. 28-17, your score. Not enough time on the clock. It was only 5 seconds on the shot clock, so Schoolcraft had to get that one off in a rush. Johnson in the paint again. No look inside underneath to Ritt, but Johnson is called for the travel. All season, Johnson has been battling an injury with his left knee. He's wearing a knee brace today. But I noticed in some earlier games, he hadn't been wearing the knee brace. Jumper from outside is good. That's Stevens for three. Johnson looking for some room there on that last play that was knocked out of bounds, but Henry Ford will retain possession and take it out underneath their basket. Ritt almost got it stolen away. Ritt, cross-court pass to Johnson, way off the mark. Keon Henderson asking for a foul there.
You know something, Jeff? I think Damian Bond, who is the second leading scorer for the Hawks, hasn't played or didn't start. So we didn't talk to Coach about whether he was injured or not, but he must be injured. So they're playing without their second leading scorer here. So they're going to need the support of that bench mightily today, losing 15 points a game.
Long three-pointer is good by Jackson.
Well, that's their leading scorer, so you got to keep a hand in his face. He's putting up about 15 a game.
Deion Hayes draws the foul.
Yeah.
I'm not mistaken, I believe it's a jersey switch. I think that is Damarion Bond, number four, if I'm not mistaken. Willis is fouled from behind.
Right? That's Damon Hayes, Mr. Lowe.
Well, it's Deion Hayes, but I believe that it might be a jersey switch.
Oh.
I believe that's Bonds. I'm not sure. We'll check that before halftime. We'll make sure the right person, maybe. Willis at the line shooting two for the Hawks. 6:19 on the clock here in the first half. Ziegler thought he got away with it. Wrapped up the offensive player. Literally wrapped him up. Had his arm wrapped around him. Short jumper, no good, off the mark, and a late whistle. Late whistle will send number 11, Daniel Lee, to the line shooting two. Real late whistle. That whistle was blown yesterday.
That's why in football they try to get the playoff quick. Jeff, you just knew that Schoolcraft was going to come in here hungry. And, you know, they was buoyant by the fact that they beat them 90-84 earlier in the year. So you knew they was going to come in here and make this game tough.
Long three-pointer off the mark right there. Rims out. Long pass up to Rosenberg.
There you go.
Good jump stop move by Rosenberg.
Rosenberg's playing a solid game for this team. And this is his last show, so maybe he's going to step in for.
Also a good pass by Willis on that last possession. Long three by Schoolcraft. Hayes brings down the rebound. Rosenberg again, that's way off the mark.
That's about the fourth three shot like that.
Dobbs was no good that time. That was blocked. I shouldn't say blocked, I should say swatted.
Swatted.
Noah Rain coming from the blind side to swat that one. 31-24, your score. Willis looking to post up and back in. Turnaround jumper's good by Willis.
Excellent shot there. Measured, methodical, took his time. And that's how you do it.
Long three-pointer rolls out. Scott with the rebound. Dangerous cross-court pass, but Willis comes away with it. Willis again taking advantage of his size. Inside to Scott. Scott couldn't get it to roll. And the putback by Rain is good.
Rain came off the bench and make his presence felt. He's a freshman, too. He's ready.
Rosenberg from outside, no good. Nice rebound and a left-hand put back by Willis.
Chauncey Willis trying to take over this game here. Some excellent basketball. Jeff,
3:46 on the clock, 35-26 your score. We got a full timeout. With this timeout, we're going to take a timeout. You're watching the Henry Ford College Streaming Network. We'll be right back after this.
Went by
35-26, 3:46 remaining here in the first half. Henry Ford with the 9-point lead.
You know, when you look at Henry Ford's measurables as a team, you know, they're averaging 92 points a game, shooting 47% from the field as a team, which is outstanding, 35% from three-pointers, averaging over 20 assists a game, but the free throw shooting at 61% as a team could cost you some close games. And that's kind of been their a thing that has kind of crept up and bugabooed them here and there.
That was Jackson with that last putback, and Henry Ford came out with some full court pressure, and Schoolcraft did a good job in breaking the full court pressure. Willis with the ball at the top. Over to Scott on the wing, behind the back pass. And a foul, offensive foul called.
That was Hayes. Anytime you lower that shoulder, you're going to get that call.
Good look inside from the top by Schoolcraft. Keon Jackson.
That's Prince. Nice old backhand layup.
Ritt from outside. Scott tried to bring down the rebound, couldn't keep the handle of it. Five-point lead for the Hawks. And a steal by the little guy that was just lurking in the backcourt.
He didn't waste no time waiting for nobody else to get back. He fired up the three.
Well, Keon Henderson just with the steal. But like you said, they didn't waste any time on the pull. The result of the play was a foul over the back foul, and it will send Willis to the line shooting a 1-1. Scott with the tip in. And his first 2 points. Nice pure jumper right there, Daniel Lee.
They're not going anywhere.
Looking for Willis again, taking advantage of his size against the smaller point guard. Couldn't finish that one off. The little man finding some room. Keon Henderson getting the rebound underneath.
He snuck in there and put it up. That was a crucial shot there. They got this thing back down under 3 points. It was a 12-point lead a minute ago.
Henderson will try the other side. And the foul is called on Henderson.
Willis is slow getting up here. Hope he's okay. Oh, he meanders back to the foul line.
Thorne checking back in the game for Schoolcraft. A minute and 15 remaining here in the first half of play. Willis makes them both and makes it a 39-34 game. Again, Henry Ford with a little pressure. And a foul on the play on number, is that number 12? Rosenberg, and that will send number 21, Ashton Henderson, to the line.
And number two, Ashton, he should be thanking Malachi Prince Jackson for getting there. I see why he's the team leading scorer and the team leading assist person, because Jackson, he keeps putting pressure on this Henry Ford defense by attacking into the paint. Jackson's going to initiate this action. Well, he kicks it on the inside. Great play. Now, that's what I would have liked to see Henry Ford do on that last possession. Instead, we got a three hoisted up. Be methodical. Take your time. Get the ball inside. Just like that.
And that shot will end the first half of play. 41-38 is your halftime score. You're watching Henry Ford College Basketball on the Henry Ford Streaming Network. I'm Jeff Lowe along with Mina Stein. And we'll be right back with more basketball after this. Welcome back to the second half, 41-38 your score. As we start the second half, and Leland, what did you see in the first half for Henry Ford and these two teams?
Well, one of the main things Henry Ford has to do, Chauncey got going a little bit and chipped in with 14, but the second leading scorer is Damian Bonds, who has a goose egg from the first half. And they're going to really get him started, Jeff, and so that they need both of them to win. Now, they've got excellent production from the bench, as they have all year long. But there he is there that we just talking about. And we want to apologize, fans. We've been mixing up Deion Hayes and Damian Bonds during the first half because they switched jerseys on us, Jeff, and didn't tell us. And Damian Bonds ripped his jersey before the game, and he switched with Hayes, who has a wrist injury, who's not playing. And that's how this jersey switch came about.
That was Jackson for three for Schoolcraft. Good ball movement for Henry Ford. Willis with the ball outside alley-oop. Play and whistles blow before. Pass was made. Foul was on the floor. Stevens now checking in. Bonds looking for some space. Good job defensively by Schoolcraft. That one's going to go off of one of the Schoolcraft players, and Henry Ford will retain possession.
It looks like Coach Shepard is going to Bonds early to try to get him going.
Rick from outside, no good. Schoolcraft comes away with it. Sprinting down the floor. That's going to be in the act of shooting as Daniel Lee grabbed the rebound. At the same time, I believe that was Scott who had grabbed his arm, but he was able to get the shot off, and that was sent him to the line.
As Henry Ford works to get Bonds back involved in the game. After having that goose egg in the first half, they've gotten excellent production from Alden Ritt, who tripped in with 8 points, and Daniel Rosenberger put 9 in. So to see if they can keep that up, they're going to need that support as this 43-43.
Outside shot for Scott was no good. Baseline move nicely done by number 21. That's Ashton Henderson.
Can't do it no better than that.
Will retain possession. Bond is caught for the offensive foul. You saw the left arm go up and a little push.
This Schoolcraft, they got a little swag going at the beginning of this half when Prince Jackson, who didn't start the first half, started out and hit that three and got this team going.
Willis to Carter. And he draws the foul. So Carter will go to the line. see Bonds getting some instruction from one of the assistant coaches. Getting a little closer. Use the shoulder instead of the elbow. And the officials can't see it.
The bank is open from the free throw line.
All tied up at 45, and some more zone pressure put on by Henry Ford. Jump stop.
Henderson averages 12 points a game, so what you're getting from him is no surprise. He can put it in the hole. Sterling effort by Sterling Scott. Slam bam.
Outside shot, no good. Rick comes down with the rebound. Scott looking to drive, tried to split the two Schoolcraft players. I believe that was number 22, Marshall Thorne, picking up the foul.
Scott coming alive here. He actually led the team in scoring in the loss to Schoolcraft in late January, dropping in 19 points a game. They'll need those 19 today.
Carter keeping it alive, grabbing the rebound and quick to back. Great effort by Carter. And also drew the foul. Hit up the foul and shoot one.
That's why when I was coaching, I always told them we work on that left hand. Even though Shannon is 6'8", if he'd have tried to shoot it with his right hand, he'd got it blocked. You know, we tell the young kids it's so important to practice playing this game with both hands, and Shannon showed us why just then. Oh, beautiful pass.
Good job by Noah Rams, number 10.
Putting in the left-hand layup.
Yeah. Got it from outside, no good. And Bond going over the back and committing the foul.
Well, coach don't be mad about those fouls. And that was a close one. He was hustling, going for the ball. And that's what you want. I see they're coming out in the full court trap here.
This full court pressure has been very effective for Schoolcraft. It's been affecting Schoolcraft, I should say. What a short jumper.
Beautiful. That was money right there.
On Daniel Lee. And Bonds will go to the line shooting a 1-1. Well, the official first indicated a 1-1, but now Henry Ford will take it out on the side. Or maybe he was indicating the jersey number of the player that committed the foul. I believe that was it. I apologize for that. Willis stumbling, finding Rick. and Sterling Scott there for the putback.
Sterling Scott has come out in the second half, giving this team a nice shot of adrenaline as it tries to hold on against this Schoolcraft team.
This half-court pressure has been giving Schoolcraft a whole lot of problems.
Up from Mexico. He was feeling it. Didn't go in. But they're going to need Bonds, though. They gotta keep trying to get him going. Nice play, Alvin. I'm glad he didn't shoot that three. I'd have jumped over the rail if he had it. But he took it to the basket. And that brings the basket, brings the crowd to his feet. It's a rush is gathering here for the Henry Ford Hawks' last home game, unless they get one in the playoffs.
8-point lead for the Hawks.
They'll have two more games after this, Jeff. They'll play St. Clair County, and Mott in their last two games, both on the road, to close out the season. If they can hang on and win this one, they'll be 9-3, so they could possibly end up 11-3. Now, I shouldn't be jinxing them by prognosticating, but 11-3 should get them some good playoff position, shouldn't it?
It should.
What do you think of those other two teams that they have to play? Do you know about them, St. Clair County and Mott? Now this no turnover time. That's what Schoolcraft's coaches said. But Coach Shepard and his troops just want to get the offense out of whack a little bit, change the flow of the game by putting on that pressure. Scott has been a spark plug. The trap. Coach Shepard's trap is causing some issues. Jackson gets breaks the press, and they do it good, you get a dunk. Acrobatics, not even great adjective, Jeff. Acrobatic is it. He did it, backed over his head, leaped over a player, tipped it in without looking. Scott has been the linchpin for the Hawks push that has got this game, got themselves a 12-point lead when they was 2 points behind. Less than 6 or 7 minutes ago, Jeff. It's been the press. The press has changed the game for this team. One thing's for sure, Henry Ford has a smorgasbord of young men that can help you. Anytime you have 9 people averaging almost 10 points a game and 2 averaging 19 and 15 along with the other 9, then that gives you a lot of flexibility and versatility as a coach.
Totally agree with that. One shot for Scott. And he makes a count. And Henry Ford has continuously put the pressure on Schoolcraft with the full court pressure. Good job for fixing the whole time.
He should have just drove it to the hoop. There's DeMarion Barnes with the alley-oop assist from half court. He's been making his presence felt all game, Joe. the big fella, he's been lugging that those 205 pounds around out there. Bond still hasn't been able to find his shot, but he's doing other things to help this team be productive and on a path to victory. But his rebounding, his hustle, and the defense. He's been a nice clog in that zone press that they implemented to start the second half here. Threw him off, huh? Threw us off, threw him off. Well, not now. The second half, he's come out with an extra burst of energy there.
And by Henry Ford. Schoolcraft breaks it. And going to the line is Prince Jackson.
You know,
2 points, 2 shots.
What makes that press more problematic is sometimes you have Alden Witt, who's 6'8", right in the middle of that zone press. That's a big person to throw the ball on, especially out in the back court. And he also has a Rosenberger, who's 6'6". You know, he'll have those two sitting in the point on that press. And it makes it hard to get that initial pass in. And the thing, Johnson had 11 points in the loss to Schoolcraft. I can see Eldon's parents up there clapping and smiling after that play. I think those are his parents, but they was pretty excited by that play, and they should be. Ziggler putting the big boy, the rough man, he's just strong arm the ball out of his arm. Ziggler weigh about 210 though. Well, it looks like you traded a doctor for an engineer, huh? As your broadcast partner.
Yes. Good switch out there. Nice three-pointer that time by Dobbs. Now Schoolcraft trying to pick up full court. Nice and tight man-to-man. Willis with the ball, looking for Johnson. Finding Johnson, and Johnson finding 2 points.
Johnson just a freshman. He put in 15 against Schoolcraft in the loss. So they got something to work with, even though they're losing some phenomenal young men through graduation. But Coach Shepherd and his staff just knows how to, they look them young men in the eye and they tell them how they can help them become better students and athletes. And it seems to work for him. Like that, Willis took his time, moved at his own pace, and was able to find a crease in there to get that shot and the foul. Riddis gave them a solid game today, even though he missed that three, but Alden is only a freshman. He'll be back too. They got something to work with here. That's the key. Easier said than done, though. Especially at this level, isn't it? Easier said than done. So,
I would say any level.
Oh, that's true. Any level. High school, college. That might be about his fifth three-pointer today, Jeff. Jackson dropped 3 out of 6 in the first half of Schoolcraft from three-point land. And if I'm correct, it looks like he's had a couple the second half. That's a pretty good shooting night for anybody. Well, you know, as we mentioned, Henry Ford College's measurables, everything has been on point except for free throw shooting. As a team, 61%, it could hurt you in the playoffs. You gotta be better.
Outside shot,
oh,
trash talking going on.
Oh, trash talking. Yeah, you're down by 15 and you're trash talking.
Outside shot off the mark. Whistles blow and Sterling Scott is called for the five.
Yeah, you gotta give Ziegler a little credit for hustle there. I mean, he missed the alley-oop, but he hustled all the way back down and really, really got in the face of that three-point shot to help knock it off target.
Dobbs makes him both. Now coming back into the game, it's DeMarion Bonds for Henry Ford. Tony Scott will check out. And now Schoolcraft applying some light pressure to Henry Ford. Nice job. Willis with the reverse layup.
Might have got him on the hand. One thing you gotta like Jackson, I mean, he's only 5'11", 5'10", but man, he puts his head down like a bull in a china shop and gets headed to that basket. And any coach would like that from one of their guards. And we got over 5 minutes left. You know, this game a long way from over because you know the 3-point can change anything.
Willis makes them both and makes it an 81-69 game.
Almost an over and back. Deep shot, no good. Ritt with the rebound. Ritt up quickly to Willis. Willis off the glass, couldn't finish it. Bonds with the rebound.
Less 5 minutes, heading toward under 5 minutes. I'd like to see the Hawks take some time off the clock, move the ball around, try to get some. They're a bigger team. Get it inside and you know just take a step back from the threes and run some clock and methodically wear this team down to close this game out.
8.69, 5 remaining. This is a full timeout. We're going to take a full timeout. We're watching Henry Ford basketball on the Henry Ford streaming network.
He said, anything you can do, I can do better, except you're behind. We'll see.
Shot off the mark. Scott comes down with the rebound. And Bynes will walk it up. Pick by Curry. High pick and roll. Scott looking for the call there. A lot of body. 3-point attempt is good. Dobbs. 11-point lead for Henry Ford. Willis from outside. Cool. 86-74.
Yeah, Jeff, as Willis bring the ball up court, the Kettering product, playing probably for the great George Ward. Mr. Basketball in Michigan in 2022, as he dribbles out the clock a little bit with 2 minutes late. He was the first athlete, Mr. Basketball, to take a Division II scholarship. And he made All-State in football and basketball at Detroit King. So we
yeah. would have stepped on the line right there, taking it out, and turns it over. So Schoolcraft will take it out underneath. That was too easy. And again,
uh-oh.
A violation.
Carelessness. Henry Ford kind of fell asleep. Sometimes when you got these nice leads, it can lull you into a sense of security. and you find yourself not with the same intensity level.
And that Bob's finishing the three-point play the old-fashioned way.
In the week of a high, we have a six-point game, seven-point game.
And now a technical foul.
A foul, nobody on the line?
Yeah, I had a technical. Now he's shooting the tech. Unless it was a double tech.
This is a two-possession game. With plenty of tech.
Whatever the case, the last 2 minutes here has been pretty interesting. Because Schoolcraft is right back in it. In a very peculiar way. They had a 12-point lead, and now it's a mistake. Just like that.
Well, again, the careless inbound play, stepping over the line, because you feel like you had a game won, and you lose a little bit of concentration, and it has cost them mightily right here.
I see an 8, but I meant 6. 88.
Well, at least the Hawk, the mascot, he was doing the funky chicken. Or I guess I should say the funky Hawk. He got the crowd revved up.
I don't think he can do a funky chicken.
The funky Hawk. So maybe some of that enthusiasm will get reinfected back into the players.
A minute and 42, but the last 2 minutes have been full of violations and penalties. Rick.
You see, Schoolcraft put on their press. Nicely done. They moved the ball around.
Bonds out the top, handling the offense.
Johnson's not the quickest or the highest jumping guard you'll see, but he's really, really kind of sneaky quick.
Thank you.
See, them free throws again, that could cost you. They got lucky that time. That long rebound off that three could be the game stamp if Willis can sink a couple of these free throws here and get it back to a three possession game. You got to be good to do them in them big claw feet. If I get down that low, I'm not getting back up. And neither are you. It's you, Jeff. Man, I give you $1,000 to do a split.
Again. I don't plan on doing it.
We're just going to let the Hawk do it.
I'll take $1,000. Right now, Henry Ford trying to hang on to this lead. Thompson Willis at the line, shooting two.
Well, Jackson put that head down. He just go, don't he? He like a little.
Foul committed in the backcourt this time. 44 seconds on the clock.
They're going to have to make some free throws. That's what these playoff games are going to come down to this as well. But all the practice and the training in the world sometimes can't get these players up over 60% on the free throw line. I know it frustrates coaches and everybody, but I've seen it over the years, no matter what. If that's your gift, that's going to be your gift. That Willis made All-State in football as well. So he's one of these rare Detroit athletes that you'll ever see to make All-State in football and basketball. Second rebound by Sterling Scott.
Yeah. And Schoolcraft has to commit a foul again. And this will put Britt on the line. And Britt will be shooting too.
Yeah, Allen was his usual steady self. Being a point man in that trap, you know, and not only that, probably contributing. He must have close to 13. Points or more. Just methodically goes about his business and helps put this team in position to win.
He has continued to be one of the top shooters in the league. and puts it back. And his own rebound and puts it back in the bucket.
This was a magnificent game. It was fun to be here. They played it out thoroughly. But this was important for Henry Ford College as they try to position themselves in their conference, which they now 9-3. And a spectacular game for Chauncey Willis Jr. Put together, carried him on his back pretty much when his second lead scorer, Damian Bonds, you know, was having a little tough time in that first half. But he came along, too, in the second half. Hey, we got the Hawk up here with us today right now.
The final score, once again, is 94-86. We'll be right back with the coaches show. Eric Page's not here, so I'll be sitting in for him.
Welcome back to Henry Ford, and your final score, once again, his 94. Uh-oh.
I think it was 94-86.
94. Hey, let's start it over real quick. Let's start it over real quick. Hello and welcome back to Henry Ford. My name is Jeff Lowe and this is the Coach's Show with Coach Shepherd. And Coach Shepherd, good victory tonight against Schoolcraft College, 94-86. And hey, you guys, as we go down the stretch and get closer and closer to March, first of all, tell us how this game kind of worked out for you.
We had opportunities to, you know, really put it on them. We were up, 15, 16 there, and then we had to make some subs. A couple of our guys were tired, and then we had to get out of the press a little bit just based on personnel. So we're getting there. We're a work in progress. Happy with our win tonight, but we got bigger fish to fry, and, you know, we're getting better. You know, we played absolutely awful at Macomb a couple Saturdays ago, and since then we've been pretty locked in from an effort standpoint. Schoolcraft played a great game today. You know, hats off to them. They competed all the way through. There's a couple times they probably could have went away, and they competed. So,
I see you, like you said, applied full court pressure on this team pretty much the entire game.
Yeah, you know, we'd like to be able to do it more. We're not as deep right now as we want to be. You know, we got Justin Gladney's, you know, battling injuries. Deion Hayes is hurt right now, and Scooby's been in and out of the lineup the same way. So, you know, it all looks great when you press and you get the steals, but when you're tired and you're pressing, you give up a layup the other way, you know? So as much as we'd like to do it, you know, as much as we could, you know, we got to be balanced with it. You know, I think you saw that. We were all over them, and then we subbed, and some of our guys that are banged up, you know, we didn't have our rotations there and, you know, kind of let them get back in a little bit.
Now, what are we looking forward to as far as tournament time and the playoffs?
Yeah, so, you know, I think we locked up that we're going to host a playoff game. We're going to figure out who our opponent is. And then after that, if you win that game, you got to play two games at Mott to go to the national tournament. So, you know, we've been there three straight years. That's our only goal. You know, that's where we want to go. We're good enough to win it if we get there. I don't know if we'll get there, but hopefully we get there. And if we can, when we're locked in, we're pretty darn good. Chauncey Willis is special tonight. I don't know what he had, but he was special.
Oh, yeah. He definitely was special.
He had a pretty good game. Yeah.
Well, Coach, I want to thank you, and I want to say good luck the rest of the way.
I appreciate all the support.
And go Hawks.
Thank you very much.
All right.
Good seeing you.
What school did Johnson go to?
Western.